The problem of aging involves a change in the availability of what's called protein peptides. And these protein peptides signal the skin, the hair, the thyroid, the glands, the back, the chest, to maintain a youthful position and enough muscle density. Human frailty is a serious problem. And as we age, we must sustain our body weight. We must sustain our workouts and exercise and use these protein peptides and amino acids that can play a big role in generating better health. The signs of aging are quite obvious. What are you doing to reverse the aging process? We know that these growth factors can enhance sexual performance, improve the sexual organs, increase energy, help you with better exercise performance, cardiac output, stronger bones, healing the wounds, muscle mass increase, reduction in body fat, less cellulite, less wrinkles, thicker skin, sharper vision, better memory, improved mood, regrowth of the organs, liver, spleen, kidney, heart, lower cholesterol, LDL, and lower blood pressure. When I first learned about this, when I was age 38, I had met Dr. Chin in Palm Springs and Dr. Neil Ruzier. And it's interesting that they knew about some of these protein peptides that far back. I started looking at natural interventions with sprays and amino acids because I wanted to duplicate what they were doing with injectable growth hormone. And I wanted to learn what could work in the herbal kingdom and the supplement arena and the lifestyle intervention. So again, always look at what you can do to slow the aging process, reverse the aging process. Can you intervene and restore the hydration? And of course, wrinkles is worsened with dehydration. Get enough water and fluids, but the problem is that when people eat so much animal protein, it dehydrates the body. It takes 8 glasses of water to digest every gram of protein that it does every gram of complex carbohydrate. So we know that certain foods are water-rich and contribute to your water hydration, like watermelon, tomatoes, celery, carrots, cucumber, and so forth. And there's foods that deplete your water and your basic nutrients, which are fish and chicken and meat, which are highly dehydrating and can cause serious water imbalances. We know that when we're looking at hormone intervention, many doctors are now using hormone pellets, particularly testosterone pellets for men, and women can use low-dose testosterone pellets. Women may need estradiol and estriol, but we know that the use of bioidentical hormones from these pellets can augment or maintain and sustain levels for 3 to 4 months at a time. We always, though, look at the herbal intervention. If someone does use bioidentical hormones from these pellets, how we can sustain the levels and maintain the best outcome to prevent loss of bone density, improve intimate function, improve the heart. These are the things that as we age, the quality of life becomes so important. My concern is that there are studies out recently suggesting that testosterone intervention is harmful. They even go so far as to say in a few recent studies that it would maintaining testosterone level may increase the rate of cardiovascular death or stroke. We look very closely at these studies. Dr. Ron Rothenberg, Dr. Neil Ruzier, and other practitioners, including Dr. Jonathan Wright, and these studies were quite flawed. If you look at it, the individuals who were treated with testosterone had a level of only 300. If they were actually being treated with testosterone, why did it only go to 300? An anti-aging doctor knows to bring the level to about 800 to 1200 to be in an optimum range. You want to mimic what it was when you were in your 20 or 30 years of life, not a level of a 50, 60, or 70-year-old. So the reason we discovered was the average person in 20% of the cases filled the prescription for the testosterone only once. So that means that once they restored once, you have to maintain and continue to sustain testosterone levels, whether it be by cream, injectable testosterone, or pellets, but one prescription would not have done it. Pellets clearly would have lasted 4 months, but they didn't use pellets in this study. 80% filled the prescription more than once, but we don't know how many times they filled the prescription, except for when they had their retest for testosterone, the level was only 300. So that clearly shows they did not follow the prescription, the protocol properly, and we know that most people who are prescribed medications of any kind rarely stick to a regime. And if they don't, then how can you compare a group of those supposedly taking testosterone against those not on testosterone and say that testosterone therapy is bad for you? If we then look at the results, the testosterone group Even though they were only taking testosterone in moderate amounts at very best, they had 5% death rate compared to 10% death rate to those not taking testosterone. So even the raw data showed they lived longer in the testosterone using group. Furthermore, there was a 9% death rate There was a 5% death rate compared to a 9% death rate in the testosterone using group, meaning that only 5% of the people died who were using testosterone compared to 9%. In events such as cardiovascular event or stroke or heart attack, 10% had a stroke or heart attack in the group using the testosterone therapy, and 21% not using the testosterone had clearly a higher incidence of stroke or heart attack. So how in the world the press got the information and were misled that a testosterone using group, that it was somehow harmful or not beneficial? It's quite the opposite. Testosterone itself, in low testosterone study groups, they have the highest rate of stroke and heart attack. And those who are augmenting to youthful levels, they maintain healthy levels and their risk of heart attack and stroke is far lower. Nia Rosier brought up an important point, and that is that people using testosterone have higher levels of hemoglobin level, but they don't have a higher rate of platelet increase. And for some mistaken reason, doctors confuse polycythemia, which is a blood disease where the individuals produce too many platelets and then they have a higher rate of stroke or heart attack. But in the testosterone using groups, they did not have a higher platelet count. In other words, the very thing that was thought to be a problem with testosterone therapy did not prove to be the case. Testosterone therapy, if monitored properly in youthful ranges by a doctor and utilizing herbs and supplements to augment and maintain youthful levels, is going to be your best outcome. Here's Arnold Schwarzenegger at his prime, and he admitted to using various anabolic steroid hormones. Now, the difference between bodybuilders and those who are looking to intervene in the aging arena is that they're using sometimes synthetic testosterone rather than bioidentical. They're using higher dosages that are sometimes 10 times the dose that a human would ever need, and they're using these protocols without monitoring their levels appropriately. So any bad press that's come about, the reality is that people like Arnold were a good test case for us to see, because we could learn from what they did right and what they did wrong. And there's better ways to augment. You can see Arnold here, but he's back in shape now, training, and we're not sure if he's intervened with more natural hormone therapies, but each person has a decision to make. And we know that testosterone therapy is safer for those who have prostate issues than no treatment at all. Over a 20-year period, 1,365 men who were augmented with testosterone, who were monitored by their PSA and digital rectal exam, according to the study published in 2012 Journal of Sex Medicine, that the results were quite clear that the individuals taking testosterone therapy had the healthiest prostate, the healthiest outcome, and the least adverse side effects. Testosterone can be natural. It doesn't have to be synthetic. You can utilize herbs and supplements and lifestyle and exercise. You can utilize, when you do need to, the intervention of Stem Cell Strong, which is a combination of medicinal herbs, beta-glucans, and other certain formula components that helps to augment your own testosterone level. But I also say that if your levels are too low, have them monitored and intervene with what therapy that you and your doctor choose.